Alrighty, welcome back. I apologize that it's been so long yet again. Last time I know that I said I was going to try to do these things a little bit quicker, and I should stop saying that because, well, here we are 2 months later and I'm just getting to another video. You guys know how I am with clickbait titles and things like that, so I'm just going to jump right into it. So we did sell our Model S.
Hi, Zeus.
And we are waiting to get a Model Y as soon as they're available. There are a few reasons behind that, and I just wanted to go over a couple of them. The first one being cost. We weren't really sold on keeping our previous Model S because it didn't have things like autopilot and the faster supercharging and things like that. And that's really big for us because we do so many road trips and put so many miles on our cars. So like I mentioned, cost. We've been looking at possibly getting another Model S with autopilot. And when we took into account the range and the supercharging speeds and things like that, we were looking at probably getting a 100D Model S, which put our price range about $76,000. And that was just too much for us. I wasn't willing to pay that. So the next option was either a Model 3 or a Model Y. We didn't get a Model 3 originally when it came out because it's not a hatchback. We have two dogs. Just wasn't gonna work out for us to try to fit the entire family in there. So we'll talk about supercharging speeds really fast. Our Model S tops out at 130 kilowatts at the supercharger and then tapers off pretty quick from there. The Model 3 and Model Y can both go up to as fast as 250 kilowatts and then it tapers off a lot slower than the Model S does. This makes for a huge difference. I have little examples here that you can see. You can see that when we come from Spanish Fork, where we live now, to Aloha, Oregon, the time goes from a little over 3 hours to just under an hour and a half. And all of our other trips, as you can see here to Kemmer, Wyoming, Burley, Idaho, and St. George, Utah, are frequent trips. Those are all cut in about half when it comes down to supercharging times. And then the range. So on our 2014 Model S 85, we had about 250 miles of range. The Model Y long range rear wheel drive will have about 300 miles range. Storage was another big thing. The Model S has about 60 cubic feet of storage. The Model Y has 66. I'd love to have the storage of the X, but that's just out of our price range. And then things like getting in and out of the car, the ingress and egress. Now this might seem kind of stupid to some people, but for us, we have older family or people that in our family that we give rides to that have had back surgeries and things like that. And the Model S has a really low top, as well as the floor sits up really high because the battery's underneath. And it just makes getting in kind of hard for those people. I mean, I'm 28 years old, I don't have any issues with it, but watching people struggle to get in and out really was kind of a hard thing for me. So we wanted to take that into account for our next vehicle. Again, this might be something that's super stupid to some people, but cup holders and door pockets. The Model S has no door pockets. I have no idea why. You'd think that after being in production for 7.5 years that they'd have started to do some, but they don't. So our 2014 Model S only had two cup holders in the front, and then it had the weird oversized cup holders that never really got used. So anytime we had passengers in the back seat, they had no place to put their drinks, even like water bottles, because there were no cup holders and no door pockets. One of the other things was autopilot. So our 2014 Model S was made before the autopilot hardware even came out. Autopilot 1 would have been okay for us, but we really wanted to be planning for the future. So getting a Model Y will have hardware 3. We're just gonna be getting basic autopilot with it, which is the traffic aware cruise control. It'll keep you in your lane, keep you from hitting the car in front of you, things like that. The full self-driving is an option that we can add on later if we want. The car still will have the hardware, but as of right now, it's not worth the $6,000 in my opinion. It does do things like the navigate on autopilot, where it will change lanes back and forth for you without you having to hit your blinker. It'll do smart summon, but other features that are supposed to come in the future, like stop sign recognition, stop light recognition, city street driving, things like that aren't fully ready to go yet. The price here in about 2 weeks is gonna go up from $6,000 to $7,000 on November 1st. But as of right now, I'm not ready to pull the trigger on that. One of the other reasons we wanted to get something with hardware 3, the autopilot hardware 3, was that it can do Sentry mode and the dash cam. Autopilot 1 and 2 can't do that. Also games like Beach Buggy, I'm not gonna really need that, but it would be fun anyways. And Tesla Theater along with karaoke, those don't work in Autopilot 1 cars right now. And hopefully we're actually getting our Model Y sooner than we'd anticipated. Originally we had planned for about December of 2020, just because that's when production was supposed to start up. Fall is what they said of 2020. And well, hopefully we can get it sooner. I'm gonna make another video about how that might be possible. And thanks for tuning in. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, comments, any suggestions, constructive criticism, please let me know. And I will see you in the next one.